All right, everyone. Welcome back to Off the Shelf Final Fantasy III. I'm Scorchy 2, and this is Figaro, South Figaro. I went around and did a little bit of level grinding for 10 or 15 minutes or so and got a couple levels up and about 10,000 GP so I can buy some items. I'm going to go to the inn now so I can heal up. That'll be a grand old time. Yeah. 80 GP? Well, no problem. I can afford that, right? No problem at all. Okay, now, let's go down to the item shop, fill up some items, and then get the F out of here. Wow, 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 bow. If you have the sprint shoes and the newer version of the game, you can sprint even faster than this. It's actually kind of crazy. It's almost too fast. This is kind of too fast sometimes. The magic lamp. Items. Push up to go up by orders of 10. Let's see. Antidote. I have a few of those. Terra has the antidote ability. Phoenix down. We shouldn't have anybody dying. Echo screen cures mute. I don't think anybody uses mute on us at this early point in the game. Let's buy tent. Have a little bit of money left over for other things. I always keep a stash of 99 healing items. That's usually the way I take it. Even if I never get down below 50, I always have 99. Hell out of here. It actually didn't take too long to do this because there's a group of enemies you can fight that occur fairly regularly. They give you about 500 GP per battle. What's that smell? Tonic. And this is favorite tea. I can sleep in the bed. Actually, I probably should have noted that. It's a free stay if you stay here, as opposed to going to the inn. But it's fine. 80 GP is not going to break anything. Flowers, his favorite. These dishes, they were his favorite. He can sleep in any bed, of course. Okay, well, that's pretty much all we find here. Just noting that Sabin was there. Sabin, he was here. Well, this guy. Hello, this guy. What the? You know this guy? Of course, he left a couple of days ago after he heard Master Duncan was slain. He headed into the mountains. I heard Duncan's son, Vargas, is missing as well. I have a bad feeling about this. So this dude just appears and then wanders off. Let's follow him. Go back outside. We have to go to Mount Kolts, which is off to the east. It's kind of hard to spot, but this is the entrance to the mountain. It's going to be our first actual real dungeon. Not really a dungeon, but you know. Mount Kolts. This place is kind of annoying. A Prowler. I forgot to buy plumed hats for the last remaining member, but that's fine. We should be okay. Let's fight our way through these dark and gloomy caves. We'll be finding tonics and winning them, so I might be using those as healing items. Hey, there's a dude up there. Going that way. Serpius. Serpinus, Snurpinus. Ah, an asshole. That was a critical hit. Whenever the screen flashes, that's a critical hit. Terra gained a level. Edgar gained a level. May as well use the tonics while we have them, right? Let's see, if we go behind this thing here, that'll lead us to... treasure box. A guardian. Yeah, it's a... just dirk, basically. It's like a dagger. That's kind of a tough one to get, because you don't think you can get behind that rock right there. But it pretty much doubled the attack power. Get attacked fairly frequently in these places. 135. The most satisfying feeling is when you get into quadruple digit damage. Won't happen for a little while, but still freaking awesome. Can I go this way? I don't know if I can go behind that thing or not. Kill the brawler! He's making me feel bad. I thought there was like a bear type creature you could get attacked by in here too. Mostly just these dudes in red pants. There's a cave. Armlet. This is... I think it's a relic. Yeah. Raises fight damage. Let's give it to Locke. Let's see. His battle power is 74, 73. The ideal choice would be to give it to Edgar, but Edgar doesn't do a lot of fighting because he uses tools. That's another thing that people tend to miss when they come in here. Atlas Armlet's a fairly decent relic to have this early on in the game, too. There's a ray of light. Maybe we'll use the MP. Get out! Tusker. Maybe this is the dude I was thinking of. They're pretty strong. It's a very strong attack. Gore basically means I'm going to stab you with my tusk. It happens a lot in bullfighting. Alright. Don't think we can go that way, so let's go up. Oh, a side attack. Wow. That was strong. Take one out, print the damage from a gore attack. One thing I always hated about enemies, depending on what kind they were, is any one of them that did, like, an attack after they, like, right before they die. Like, it's a parting move or whatever. I think flying enemies are actually particularly weak to that thing, too. And the nice thing is, the tool attacks never miss. Unless there's, certain ones that, are like status ailments or something like that. There's actually a tool we can get later that has the chance of instant death. that one misses, but it still attacks and does damage if it's not able to kill. We'll get that one later too. It'll be fun. Small puzzle involved in figuring that one out. Okay, let's go. This is not a particularly long area, it's just kind of annoying. Let's use fire. That plant can poison us, I do believe. More enemies usually means more XP. Certain enemies carry more GP than others, so it doesn't always equate to that, but I always thought was kind of cool about this game too is that it tracks your steps. So by the end of the game, if you've done a whole lot of extra shit, you have a lot of steps. Hopping down the mountain, whoever that is. I always hate when enemies hit the same person over and over again. So annoying. He can hop down the mountain and I have to take the stupid rope bridge. Preemptive strike. Don't waste it, because the enemies will have a chance to attack you even if you don't attack first. Preemptive strike, if you haven't been able to tell, is one where your attack gauges start full, so you get the first attack. Alright, now we got a chance to save, and I think we're good. Let's use a... Got an idea, let's do this. I was gonna use a sleeping bag, but they're still kinda... I don't really need one. And they're a lot more expensive than tonics. Erasing data is fine, thank you. I don't know why you wouldn't take the chance to save and heal at any save point you ran across. Wander down this whole spiral thing here. Oh god, not these things. Kill it, kill it, kill it! Damn. God damn it. Poison is for the bullshit. Poison means that whenever you walk, you take damage. It's one of the few status ailments that remains after battle. You can cure it with an antidote, or you can use a spell. And if you're in battle and you get poisoned, you slowly take damage every round. It's all in all, it's not devastating, but you don't want to screw around with it. Missed! Because we are wearing the little thing that protects us against it. Any enemy that does a status ailment regularly is irritating. The ones that end after battle are fine, but pain in the ass. Do enough damage. There we go. Yeah! Yeah, I gained a level. Yay, Edgar! There's somebody. Who are you? I always like when I can take out all of the enemies at once. Hello. Sabin sent you, right? Pounced. Who are you? Sabin? See here. You were shadowing us earlier, right? Brilliant! And how unlucky it is that you have run into me. Oh no, it's a boss fight, and he's got the bear enemies. We have to kill the bear enemies. We can't attack Vargas. It's an Aipu. They're not particularly strong, but... he has the power to do heavy damage to you. And I have magic too. Thank you. So now we're just gonna keep doing damage to Vargas. Vargas is out of control, clearly. Enough! Off with you now. Give it up, Vargas! Is that you, Saban? What? Vargas, why'd you do it? How could you do your own father like that? Fool, he made the mistake of choosing you as his successor. He snubbed me, his only son. No, you were the one he chose. You're a liar! Our master wanted you to be his successor, not me. He appreciated your fine spirit. Enough of your lies. Now have a taste of my superior technique. Mortal attack, blizzard fist. It's not really mortal. Not for me, at least. Ah, Saban. The master taught you well. I guess there's no avoiding this. Fate made us train together, and fate will send you to your doom. Doom fist. Blitz. So we'll talk about Blitz in a little bit here. Whoa, what the? He already taught you that? If only you hadn't been in such a rush for power. And then he goes away. Saban! My brother! Big brother? Brothers are reunited. Now let's get the fuck out of here. Younger brother? At first glance, I thought he was some bodybuilder who had strayed from his gym. That's funny. Bodybuilder? I'll take that as a compliment. Scoff if you will. Anyway, brother, what are you doing here? We're on the way to the Sable Mountains. To the Returner hideout, no doubt. I've been watching from afar, hoping that the world might regain some sanity. At this rate, Figaro will be reduced to a puppet state. No, not at all. Our time to strike back has arrived. The Empire is going to pay for what it has done. Think a bear like me could help you in your fight? You join us, Saban? I think Duncan would rest easier if he knew his disciple played a part in bringing peace to the world. Let's get going. How easy it is to simply just say, I'm gonna help out. I'm gonna reorganize people here. I always put Saban in the front, because, you know, he can wear a buckler. All these people are on their shit. And let's talk about Blitz real fast here. So Blitz is Saban's technique. Their controller movements. So the one I used was Pummel. Cuts through an enemy's defenses. It's left, right, left when you select Blitz. This one here is the Aura Blast, I believe. It's basically just down to the left quarter movement of the D-pad, so if you're a Street Fighter fan or any of those fighting games, you'll know those. This right here is a suplex, doesn't always work, but it's pretty powerful if you can remember to use it. The thing I hate about the blitzes is in this game is that if you don't remember the button combo, you can't do anything. And if you mess up, it's a waste of a turn, so be careful. Kent. Get out. And I got attacked at the last step. But let's use the blitz. We'll use the suplex on him. See if it actually works. It did work. That's cool. I always fuck up Aura Bolt if I use it too much, because sometimes I miss the diagonal movement, but that's a pretty strong one for a single enemy. Where you walk all the way up. These are the enemies I was talking about that have the significant amount of money. Walk all the way up the valley here. Hideout. Boop, 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 boop. Cure. Feel the healing light. He stabbed him with a fork. Saban is one of the few characters in the game that can actually wield two weapons with both hands. So once we get another weapon, we'll be able to utilize some of his attack power. Okay, so this is a natural breakpoint. When we come back, we will enter the Returner's hideout and start this fight towards world peace. I'll see you later. Thanks for watching.